Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the commanding officer, Colonel Andrew M. Regan, welcome to the relief and appointment ceremony, where Sergeant Major Robert W. Pullen will relinquish the office of Battalion Sergeant Major to Sergeant Major Edward D. Parsons. Today's parade is being executed by the enlisted Marines of Headquarters and Service Battalion, Henderson Hall. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the invocation given by Chaplain Chad Goddard, United States Navy.
Let us pray. Almighty God, as we gather today, we are reminded of the great privilege that we have to serve our nation. Today, we look back with honor on the tremendous leadership that Sergeant Major Pullen has shown during his time here at Henderson Hall. May your blessing and protection remain upon him and his family as they move on to serve elsewhere. Today, we look forward with anticipation to the leadership of Sergeant Major Parsons. Give him the discernment, character, and courage to be an effective leader of Marines. Watch over us now in the ceremony, but above all, watch over our Marines who are deployed in harm's way. I pray these things in your holy name. Amen.
Thank you. Please be seated. The commander of troops for today's ceremony is Master Sergeant Tracy A. Washington. The adjutant for today's ceremony is Gunnery Sergeant Esteban D. Arroyo. Present-day parades in the Marine Corps have their basis in both history and tradition. The massed formation of troops on one long line at close interval made possible the massing of firepower from muzzle-loaded muskets of yesterday. In those early days, the line of battle was just that, a line of two or three ranks and looked much like the parade formation you will see today. The adjutant formed the line for battle. Historically, it was at this point that commanding officers would issue orders and instructions to the unit commanders. Following this, the unit leadership would face about, return to their units, and pass the information along to their Marines. Ladies and gentlemen, now taking his position in the reviewing area is the commanding officer of Headquarters and Service Battalion, Headquarters Marine Corps, Henderson Hall, Colonel Andrew M. Regan.
Sir, the parade is formed. Staff, order.
Comrade of the Marine Corps, 2. Sergeant Major Robert W. Pullen. Effective 10/28 February 2017, you stand relieved from your present duties as the Sergeant Major for Headquarters and Service Battalion, Headquarters Marine Corps, Henderson Hall. Signed, General Robert B. Mellor, comma, of the Marine Corps.
Good morning, sir. Sergeant Major Pullen reporting as the old Sergeant Major. Thank you, sir.
From Commandant of the Marine Corps, 2, Sergeant Major Edward D. Parsons. Effective 10/28 February 2017, you will assume all duties as the Headquarters and Service Battalion, Headquarters Marine Corps, Henderson Hall, Sergeant Major. Signed, General Robert B. Mellor, Commandant of the Marine Corps.
Good morning, sir. Sergeant Major Parsons reported to new Sergeant Major. Aye, sir. Aye, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for honor to our national colors. Challenge the contemporary relevance of all training from annual requirements to return. retiring and transition services. Appointed as the Marine Corps' representative to the Armed Services Retirement Home Budget Statement Committee, his financial skills proved instrumental to the development of a feasible budget that extends the fiscal viability of the home and sustainment of services to the residents. As a battalion senior enlisted advisor, his expertise served the need and requirements of four deputy commandants and the director, Marine Corps staff. Confident in his wisdom and connection to their assigned Marines, his professional knowledge and candid guidance was often sought by these senior leaders. Sergeant Major Pullen's exceptional professional ability, steadfast initiative, and selfless dedication to duty reflected great credit upon him and were in keeping with the highest traditions of the Marine Corps and the United States Naval Service. For the President, General Robert B. Neller, Commandant of the Marine Corps.
Hey, good morning, everybody. What a great day. Beautiful day to be here, here at Henderson Hall. For those of you that are residents, first let me just say welcome. Special guest today is everybody that is in attendance. But please excuse me for acknowledging a few. Sergeant Major Troxell, thank you so much for taking the time out of your busy schedule to be here today. Sergeant Major Green, thank you. Welcome back to Henderson Hall. He was a Sergeant Major here years ago, so thank you so much. Pullen family, Melissa, great seeing you again. Thank you so much for everything that you do. Welcome to the Parsons family. Great to have you aboard here today. Fellow commanders, Colonel Duggan, thanks for taking the time. Sergeant Major Donaldson, thank you for being here. Sergeant Major Von Ostrom, thank you. And Mr. Shelton. Yes, I am the Lieutenant Commander. He always said that. So it makes me feel good. Oh, Scott, excuse me. Thank you. And Joe Murray, I know you're out there somewhere. Thanks for taking the time. And if I didn't mention your name, I don't mean to be rude, because there's a lot of great folks here today showing some tremendous support for the battalion, and I greatly appreciate it. I did not forget Sergeant Major Gray, because when I was out here and I was practicing for this thing, I was thinking to myself, I worked with Sergeant Major Gray back at the University of South Carolina. We were cohorts back there. And I saw where he was and his precision with the drill, and I was thinking to myself, oh man, don't screw this up, don't let Sergeant Major Gray down. And then I had added pressure, because Sergeant Major Parsons was the assistant drill master over at the barracks. So what I thought would be like, you know, hey sir, you just gotta come up here, you know, stand out in front of people, and it wasn't complex, but when you have that type of experience and pressure behind you, you know, it's all there. But no, thanks so much for being here this morning. It is a wonderful day. The Marines look great. I want to thank the quartet. My geometry's off, so I don't know what to call a band of five. But music players, thank you so much. Thanks. Every time the Joint Base puts on something, we have the professionalism of the Army Band, and it's great to have you guys over here sharing in our ceremony today. If you talk to Sergeant Major Green will tell you to read and remember the past. So, Sergeant Major, we read and remembered the past, and the last time there was a posted appointment here in February in this area. It was 6 degrees out, and there was snow on the ground. Not sure if Sergeant Major Green was trying to prove something when he was appointed the 18th Sergeant Major of the Marine Corps, but we remember, we look back. You know? So of course we plan, we planned it for the indoor ceremony, and I know it was the outdoor. I know it was the outdoor. Yeah, I'm sure it was. But so we planned it for inside here today. Wow, what a beautiful day outside. So, but anyway, we all know why we're here. This is another unit military tradition, and it is a wonderful tradition. We are graced with the presence of some tremendous Marines that stand behind me, and what we're doing today is recognizing the pinnacle of their professionalism with the post and relief of the Sergeant Major of this battalion. And it goes on throughout every unit in the Marine Corps, but that's what we're looking at today. The Sergeant Major to me reflects the pinnacle of professionalism of our enlisted ranks. I've been blessed once again to have a tremendous Sergeant Major as my Sergeant Major, and I love saying that, my Sergeant Major. As a commander, you get to have that close confidant with you. And I couldn't have been more fortunate to have Sergeant Major Pullen and Melissa with me. So with that, I'd like to also thank the challenges and the folks that are involved in selecting our Sergeant Majors. I know there's many Marines that are qualified to do it, but when you get to the level of Sergeant Major, slicing and dicing, who goes where and who does what, who makes it, has got to be a very challenging task. And because you're dealing with the best of the best, and you know, it always seems to work. It's a tough task, and I'm glad, Sergeant Major Pullen, that you are recognized once again when you leave here to go on and serve the IG office and serve General Colonies over there. I congratulate you on that selection. You'll do a wonderful job to serve our Corps in a higher capacity. I know you are happiest, and if you were to be here and watch Sergeant Major Pullen in action, this man is the happiest when he's in front of a formation and leading. I'm not sure what Mr. Shelton and the IG crew do over there in terms of leading formations, Sergeant Major Lamposi can fill you in on all that. But that said, I know that's where you're happiest, but we're going to use the institution has chosen to use your talents in a different capacity. And we had Sergeant Major Pullen involved in some different things here that are probably a little untraditional to the normal billet. But one of the areas that he did make a great impact is on the Marine Corps Community Services side of the house. We put him on the interview panels that were there. And every time the folks did an interview panel for a new job applicant, it always came out, wow, what a great thing it was to have the Sergeant Major there. How much he added. So your level of understanding of the individual and aligning that with the mission and the process that is required is a tremendous strength of yours. And I know it's going to serve you well when you move over. You've had a great couple of years here. You've embraced the responsibilities. You've embraced the community. It's evident because we have some of your neighbors here. I thank you for helping us be good residents of the Joint Base and fostering a relationship with the great leadership that we have on the Meyer side. You're a critical part to that, and I thank you so much for investing yourself and Melissa, you too investing in that, because it helps the base, it helps the community. I believe it helps Colonel Doug and Sergeant Major Donaldson, and it ultimately helps the Marines that we serve. Sergeant Major Parsons, welcome aboard. I think you're going to get a touch and go with me for a few more months here. I think you had a touch and go with another family member of mine. I think you were with my cousin in, did you go to Najaf when you were in Iraq? So I think you might have touched base with my cousin there for a month, Chris Conlon. You probably caught him on the way out the door there. So obviously there's something in the plans there with Parsons around the Regan family, right? Oh. So you I'm sure, you know, again, part of the plan, I'm sure. But great to have you. Christina, welcome. the Parsons clan is kind of all over the place. You know, four kids, Alicia, Gunner, Major, and Elizabeth. Some are finishing school, some are out of school. Army officer, so another Army presence here amongst us. But Sergeant Major's up here on his own for a couple months till the kids finish school. And then they'll be moving up here to the area and moving on base. So you'll have another Marine Corps Sergeant Major on the installation to add to the mix. So looking forward to getting everybody up here once all said and done. And thanks for dealing with the situation for what it is. It's never easy to split the family up, but those are the sacrifices that you guys make and your professionalism and commitment to the institution, which reflects a great commitment to these Marines here, is very well appreciated. Nothing but great things, I'm sure, lie ahead for you. You've accomplished so much already. There's a great deal for you to continue on that path that's here. Sergeant Major Pullen can fill you in on all the intricacies, but I think this is a tremendous place. Despite the organization and how it's spread out, it's not your concentrated, you know, fall in. 10 people will fall in front of you. It's not like, you know, are these my Marines? Yes, there it is. That's it. Leadership is leadership. And you know, you get out and about, and we're lucky to have you. We're looking forward to all the great things and talents that you bring here. So, welcome. Pullens, probably the only time that you'll leave the post of the battalion sergeant major, but not leave the battalion, right? He's going to Alpha. Not quite sure how to explain it, but that's how it works around here. So you won't be going far. Great to have you in the neighborhood still. Look forward to seeing you around here at Henderson Hall. You know you're always welcome here. And once again, from the officers, staff NCOs, and Marines of the battalion, thank you. That sums up how I feel. That sums up what you've accomplished, and what can you say? I wish you nothing but the best. Hoorah.
Okay, so for my speech, I decided that I better type this thing last night. I was a little groggy when it happened, so please excuse me, and I'm going to stay anchored to that thing to stick to the script, because if I don't, it can get weird in here, okay? Okay, so to start off, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to thank each and every one of you for taking time out of your very valuable schedules to be here. I know this is a busy time. This is definitely a busy place. It means a lot to see the crowd here, the amount of folks. We had to put overload chairs on to fit everybody in the seats. I'm humbled to have in the crowd today the senior enlisted advisor to the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, Command Sergeant Major Troxell. It's a mouthful. The Sergeant Major of the Marine Corps, Sergeant Major Green, Sergeant Major Manpower and Reserve Affairs, Sergeant Major Van Ostrom. Thanks for fighting traffic coming up here. I chose 1000 on a Tuesday specifically just to test the system, okay? I'd also like to welcome the Deputy IG of the Marine Corps, Mr. Shelton. Thank you for coming over here today. I look forward to working with your office and look forward to working with you. You're going to have to train me on DTS a little bit. Sergeant Major Joe, Sergeant Major Lamposen, my old battle buddy from back in the day. We were corporals together. Who else have we got here? Sergeant Major Biggs, thank you for taking time out of your schedule to be here. I know you're very busy also. So if I was to name all the guests here and all the special people that we have here visiting today, the Marines would have to take a chow break. So, if I don't by name you, I really apologize, okay? I would like to welcome the many, many other sergeants major that are in the crowd. I don't think you could swing a dead cat right now without hitting one of them. There's that many. I would like to welcome the Joint Base Myer-Henderson Hall Command Team. Thank you for coming here, and thanks for being a great host to the battalion. I think we got a great relationship, and there's a good thing going on this base. I'd also like to welcome the MCI NCR commander and command team, wherever y'all are at, sir. I don't know, I can't see you. Additionally, Wounded Warrior Regiment, thanks for coming up the road here. And I know you're mainly here for Sergeant Major Parsons. That's a testament fighting that traffic north to come see him, of how much you love him. We also have Marine Barracks Washington. Your boss is not here, I don't think, right? But Sergeant Major Gray, thanks for coming. And who else do we have here? Have lots of neighbors and friends from the Joint Base. Mr. David Metzger, sorry I didn't shake your hand when you came in. You must have been late. And there's also some Marines from my past units here. But I'm not going to go down the list because it'll take forever. First, I would like to say that this tour, hands down, has been one of the most unique experiences I've ever had in the Marine Corps during my time in the Corps. Once I got the phone call and knew that I was coming here, when I left Camp Lejeune, I had a notion of what H&S Battalion Headquarters Marine Corps was. I can tell you right now, I was totally freaking wrong about the whole thing. When I showed up here in March of 2015, I felt like they had put me in some type of space capsule, and it landed on Mars, and I got out. And I was just trying to figure out this weird environment that is up here. But the thing that really helped me understand this was the education I received from Mr. Craig Cressman. He's here. I see him looking out into the rafters, thinking about the good old days. Thanks for the turnover. Thanks for the insight on the battalion. You enabled me to hit the ground running. I attribute the rest of my education really to the Marines in the battalion. Everybody accepted me with open arms. They really helped me kind of figure this thing out. So I really do appreciate that. For those that are not familiar with the structure of the battalion, we run about 1,600 to 1,700 strong, depending on the time of the year. We are top heavy. Instead of being shaped like a normal unit, like a pyramid, we are like a V shape, okay? Early last week, we had approximately 1,000 officers administratively assigned to the battalion, about 360 staff NCOs, and the remainder of that 1,600 were sergeants and below. That's it. We have Marines in the Pentagon, Navy Yard, NSF, Naval Support Facility, Fort Meade, Quantico, Charleston, South Carolina, San Diego, California, Afghanistan, at embassies throughout the world, the State Department, Capitol Hill, the Mark Center, JIATO, DLA, DITRA, JPPSO, that's like DMO, down at Fort Belvo, if I got it right, Gunny will school me later. NDU, National Defense University. We have Marines, I can't even name them all. There are so many acronyms. We have Marines who work in small groups or alone and unafraid throughout the NCR and the world. Headquarters Company, which resides here at Henderson Hall, is a very small contingent of Marines whose sole mission is to support the Marines in the battalion. I know that sometimes this support is not seamless. However, I know that the Marines of Headquarters Company work hard to support all others in the battalion. For their efforts, I would like to thank them, all Marines of Headquarters Company, for the hard work that you do. I would urge each and every one of you to not get comfortable, to find ways to better support the Marines that are out and about in the battalion. What you do is vitally important to Headquarters Marine Corps. I want to thank the officers, staff, NCOs, and Marines of the battalion for the support which you provide to the mission. What you do for this great organization is vitally important to the end user. And by end user, I mean the units who are out there operationally completing the mission, okay? So we support the entire battalion. The battalion supports the entire Marine Corps. It's very important. I've been fortunate when it comes to commanders, okay? At the beginning, I had Colonel Barnes, who got tired of looking at me, so he retired. And since July 2015, Colonel Reed. Both gave me great examples of what the battalion commander should be. Unlike many other battalion commanders I've interacted with, Colonel Reagan, I have to say, you're a natural at this command thing, okay? You get it, and you truly care about the Marines and sailors of this battalion. You absolutely do. You have a tough job. You do it extremely well. Sometimes I would not want to be you. You're a great commander, and it's been a pleasure to work with you. I would follow you anywhere. Thanks for listening to my advice, although at times it may have been a little out of whack, okay? But I'm a senior enlisted advisor, I advise. But as we were talking the other day, I don't think there was a lot that, you know, we really banged heads about. Very easy to work with, and you truly do get it, sir. So thank you. And thank you for the kind words earlier. I would like to publicly thank our company first sergeant. Yeah, you. First Sergeant Connor, okay? If you look at H&S Battalion Headquarters Marine Corps on paper, it lists three companies, Headquarters Company, Alpha Company, and Bravo Company, and about 17 and change personnel. We have one first sergeant. One first sergeant, okay? So he handles the load of three companies, basically the entire battalion. Their paperwork goes through the company office and up to battalion. He does it with ease, okay? And these Marines are dispersed throughout the world. So thanks for your efforts. I really appreciate it. I sleep good at night knowing that you're on the job. I absolutely do. To the Marines in formation, thank you for all your hard work and support to this event. We talked yesterday, so I'm not gonna say anything else. As always, you look good. You perform with professionalism, snap and pop. Additionally, I would like to thank the Marines from the band who supported this event. Shook your hands earlier. Make sure you get a little snack before you leave. Just don't run away. Your efforts, like I said, bring a lot of class to this ceremony, okay? Otherwise, we're pushing the button on an iPod. It's kind of lame. So, I really appreciate your support in coming out here today. The Marine Corps has made a smart investment in selecting Sergeant Major Ed Parsons to come into this battalion. I welcome you and Christina, and I know that you will take this battalion to the next level. You definitely will. You have an outstanding demeanor. You are definitely the right guy for this job. I don't know who picked you to come up here, but you're the right guy. You're definitely the right guy. If you didn't know, if y'all in the crowd didn't know it, I'm going over to the IG's office next. And Ed, I look forward to being assigned to your Alpha Company while you're part of this command. And I promise I will not be a pain in your rear end. Now, I would get in trouble if I didn't recognize this next person. This is the part where I have to thank my wife. I would like to publicly thank my wonderful wife, Commander-in-Chief Pullen House, Melissa Pullen. You've been with me through thick and thin. I've drug you all over the world. You run our household like a fine-tuned machine. And if it wasn't for you, don't roll your eyes. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be successful at this, okay? Because you backed me up. I appreciate everything that you do, and I cannot wait to go skinny dipping with you when you are 80 years old. So I gave her the wave toss of the speech last night, but I didn't clue her into that. I love you, and I appreciate what you do. Okay, I'm almost done, people. Even though we're coming together for this relief and appointment, I would like each of you to know, and I hear Colonel Regan always say this, this is not about me, it's about the institution. This is about the beast that is Headquarters and Service Battalion, Headquarters Marine Corps. That's what this is about. It's about the mission we accomplish on a daily basis. It's about the Marines who are currently in our Corporal's Course. It's about the daily functions within the Deputy Commandant's offices down in the Pentagon. It is the support which is provided to the fleet from Headquarters Marine Corps. It's about the mentorship. It's about the building strong leadership foundation in the unit. Because I, not unlike many other sergeants major, have come and gone, okay? We come in, we have an awesome opportunity to serve our Corps, but in the end, we will get replaced. Hopefully on a good note. The constant factor in this whole equation is the battalion, the unit, and the Marine Corps. That's why we're here, not because of me. Okay, I believe I've said all my thanks, and that's my little piece of advice, and Melissa's waving me off, so she's like, shut up. In closing, I thank you all for coming here today. I appreciate the opportunity, which I have in the next couple years, to continue to serve in this battalion, but serve the Corps on a different level. I hope that you take a few minutes after this to mingle with us and have a few light refreshments. Thank you, and Semper Fidelis.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sergeant Major Parsons.
Wow. Sergeant Troxel, Sergeant Green, Colonel Regan, Mrs. Regan, Sergeant Red Ostrom, Sergeant Joe, Sergeant Majors, Colonel Campbell, Sergeant Simberger, Sergeant Gray, friends, families, fraternity brothers that showed up. This is probably the most humbling opportunity that Joint Base commanders, I can't forget you all. I've been hit with so many acronyms this week that I don't know what the letters of the alphabet are. Joint P's and C's and D's and F's and G's, and I didn't know what to expect. Sergeant Pullen mentioned the phone call. I thought I was getting pranked. I went high to the right over the phone and said some things I probably shouldn't have said. And then Master Gunner Sergeant, and I'm glad you're here too, Master Gunner Sergeant. Thank you for being here. Master Gunner Sergeant Hunt said, hey, calm down, man. The boss wants to talk to you. It's like, what boss? He's like, the boss. So I talked to Sergeant Major Green over the phone. He said, so what do you know about Headquarters Marine Corps? Sergeant Major, I know absolutely nothing. Nothing about it. I am probably the lowest, nastiest grunt that is right around the Marine Corps. I promise you that. I barely know how to spell CAD, but I can do it on the radio pretty efficiently. But what I do know is leadership is transparent. Leadership is transparent to everything that we do, regardless of the unit, regardless of the organization. You, we, me, as a leader, I have to be humble enough to come to you and tell you that I don't know. I don't know about JOA. I don't know about Joint, the Pentagon, and other outlying places, but I'm training. I'm training. I promise you 150% of me. 100% of Ed Parsons will come to you every day. Master Gunner Sergeant, I'm coming to you and I want to jump in your back pocket because I don't know. I don't know what it is that you do. I don't know what it is, where your Marines are, except for on my mortar report, which Sergeant Major Pullen went with me over for the last 5 days, and I was in awe. As I see you looking around, we're going to be spending some time together. Me and you. Because that mortar report is important because it tells me every little detail of where Marines are. It tells me the things that I need to do and where I need to be at because I want to see you, where you are, at your level, because I don't know. Headquarters Marine Corps is this thing that us in the fleet, we see it, saw it as a, I saw it as a fictitious thing that Mar admins came out of. And Mar bulls and white letters, and they don't know what they're doing up there. Well, now I'm up here and I'm scratching my head. And you Marines right here, these Marines are the ones that are making it work. They're one-man fighting holes every single day, and they're getting, they're putting in the work every single day. Some of them are doing it on their own. I want to go there. I want to be there with you. I want you to see and experience the things that you do. I promise to be your sergeant major. I promise to be a humble servant. Humble is something I got to work on, but I promise you I'm going to do it. Because that is a challenge to myself. Colonel Campbell, Sergeant Major Simberger, I cannot thank you enough for the opportunity that you gave me at Wounded Warrior Battalion. Unorthodox, some of my methodologies, but you taught me how to look at things through another box, through another lens. That lens is now here at Headquarters Marine Corps, and I have to look through it, and I have to hone it, and I have to polish it to see things through another level, at another level, and I thank you for that, gentlemen. I'm going to be brief. Christina. My love, my wife. I've drug her all over the world, like Sergeant Major Pullen and Melissa Per. I've drug you all over the place. I've given you 2 hours notice that I'm deploying for a year, and here I am again. I'm telling you the same thing. 150% is going to be given to these folks for this assignment. That does not mean that I forget about you. That means I got to figure out the balance. As you continue to work on your doctoral work, I promise you I'm going to be there. I'm going to be your unofficial editor, because I know you will be mine. Thank you. And lastly, I would be remiss if I did not thank my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Without him, I wouldn't be here. I'd have been left in Anna Jeff, sir, working for your cousin. Sergeant Joe, yeah, I heard. Sergeant Joe, you and I go way back. My first tour in Iraq. Yo, thank you, Tom Smoker, because you didn't have to. Guy Taylor. All right. And to the folks that have adopted me back into D.C., the whites. Eric and Linda, thank you all for taking in Sergeant Major in your basement up there in Northwest. It was because you didn't have to, and you did. And I hope to be a good tenant for you in the time that I'm there. But thank you all. Thank you all for everything. For those of you that are in the crowd, our Supreme Marines, NCCS, and everybody else, I look forward to coming in and seeing what you all do. I am your Sergeant Major also. If you need me, my door hangs on welcome hinges. If it's closed, not, I'll tell you coming in. But I am your Sergeant Major too, and please don't forget that. And I am Sergeant Major Green, and I am humbled to assume the office of Sergeant Major here at Emerson Hall. Thank you.